Greetings, Eric Backer, naturopath from New Zealand, author of Candida Crusher. Thanks for checking out my video. Today we're going to talk about a yeast called Geotrichum. So you don't see much about this really on Dr. Google. You don't read a lot about Geotrichum. You can find it on the Wikipedia page, but you're not going to see a hell of a lot of stuff written about it. All the focus is on Candida, Candida, Candida. Some practitioners talk about Aspergillus or aspergillosis, which we'll talk about later on. But this video is going to focus on a yeast called Geotrichum. I've noticed this with various different stool test results with patients over the years. I typically find it elevated in people who like dairy products, especially soft cheeses, Camembert, brie, or these sort of cheeses. But also I found interesting, there's an association between the Geotrichum yeast and certain types of fruits. It's also associated, in my opinion, with people who eat too much citrus fruit, or certain types of sweet fruits. So when I see it, an elevation in a stool test, that's my question to the patient, what do you like to eat? And sometimes there's a correlation between like citrus fruit consumption or high sweet fruit consumption or soft cheese consumption and this Geotrichum. One of my patients who works in a cheese factory had a hugely high level of Geotrichum and many other unusual yeast strains. But she said she's walking around the cheeses all the time, inspecting them. So she's working in an environment full of molds in the air. So Geotrichum can cause a condition called geotrichosis. It's not what I got. Geotrichosis, especially pulmonary, so it can affect the lungs, a little bit like this other yeast called Aspergillus that can also affect the lungs quite a lot. So you get pulmonary, there are different types of conditions that can be affected. The sputum can be tinged a little bit yellow or creamish, for example. It can affect the gastrointestinal tract. About 25 to 30% of people have got this naturally occurring in their gut, a little bit like Candida. So not everybody has Candida colonized in their digestive system. So the belief is that everyone's got Candida. It's only, you know, when it overgrows, it becomes a problem. But it's not true. Not everybody has got Candida naturally colonized in their gut. And it's the same with the Geotrichum. So once this is cultured in the stool and it starts showing high numbers, I know it's a problem. But the good news is Geotrichum I find a lot easier to work on than other yeasts like Candida. And it responds particularly well to Candida Remove, the product I've made. In nearly all cases, I've seen Geotrichum go to zero once we've been working with Candida Remove for about 2 or 3 months. It works particularly well when you take the Remove and the Restore. So Candida Restore and Candida Remove together has a usually good effect. Diet, of course, needs to be changed too. So the good news is I don't find it as invasive or as troublesome. But if you've got like a problem with sinus or you're coughing, you've got lung issues, various other conditions like that, it could be Geotrichum. Also interesting with vaginal infections, it can be a bit of a problem. I've just been reading here about the vaginal geotrichosis. So it's similar to thrush. There can be a white discharge. But the vaginal geotrichosis is more common in pregnant women than in non-pregnant women. So if you, for example, had a culture done, a vaginal swab, and they can't find any candida, maybe they didn't check for Geotrichum, okay, because it's another yeast. There's hundreds of different types of yeast that can affect people. But unfortunately, all the focus is really on Candida. But there are dozens and dozens of different types that we see in stool test reports. And no doubt there are many species that don't even check for that could be a problem. So don't worry. Most of these yeasts respond very well. Well, the imbalance of the yeast respond very well to diet change and supplementation like the Candida. So that is the good news. So if you hear that word again, Geotrichum, now you know what it is. It's a yeast. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to click the link below if you haven't already got my report. Thank you.